Hey guys, it's your boy Malik on Fleet 3.0. We're back at it with UFC 3, My Career, Episode 3.
All right, coming up next is the UFC Flyweight Division matchup. All right, so here he is, a very accomplished striker, finally making the walk to the octagon tonight. Gotta think he'll be interested, of course, in keeping this fight standing in his wheelhouse. And he's got the takedown defense to keep this fight where he wants it. No doubt he'll be looking to put on a striking clinic here tonight.
This guy is an outstanding striker. What he wants to do is use his defense to keep the fight standing, use the takedown defense in a good solid sprawl. And if he does go to the ground, make sure he gets back up and punishes his opponent.
Well, this is an outstanding kickboxer making his way to the UFC Octagon right now. Very interesting stylistic matchup here tonight. Just an outstanding arsenal of kicks. Great punching technique. Power in both hands. Works the lead leg. Not afraid to work the body. Just a complete kickboxer here. Now applying his trade in mixed martial arts. A dangerous proposition for anyone caught in his striking range.
This guy is a great striker. What he wants to do is land hard and early, get the respect of his opponent, and avoid any grappling exchanges.
And now on tail the tape for this flyweight tilt. More than 5 years apart, with similar height and some differences in reach.
He's about to get this work.
Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC flyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a kickboxer, only professional ever done. 1 win, 1 loss. He's had 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighing in 120 pounds. Fighting from Washington, USA, and now the division is alone, fighting out of the red corner, a kickboxer. Only a professional record of 4 wins, 3 losses. He's got his 5 feet 6 inches tall, weighing in at 124 pounds. Awesome!
Yeah, he was into a zone. He's gonna catch his work, though.
Dan Mergliotta. Dan Mergliotta.
Ready?
And we are underway. All right, ready to go for round one. And this young man's popularity absolutely soared on the strength of what he did his last time out. It was a win by flush knockout. Kept his winning streak intact with style points. And now, the challenges get decidedly more tougher. We'll see if he can keep the momentum going in what is unquestionably the biggest spot of his UFC career.
Blocking all the shots coming towards his head.
All right, so here we go with round one, and it doesn't figure to take him long to start to establish his kicking game, Joe. He's got some of the most powerful kicks in his division. He does not discriminate. He'll go to the body. He'll go up top. Let's see how the early portions of this one play out.
Nice jab.
These guys are swinging.
And that one certainly found the target.
Oh, big shots. He's doing a great job blocking these shots. It appears he has a cut on his nose.
Just over 3 minutes to go, round one. Trying to set up the straight left, but he missed. Oh, he got pressure with the jab there, Joe. His head is firmly on the center line, the one place it really can't afford to be. He's showing some vulnerability here by leaning right into his opponent's range. Let's see if he can make some adjustments here. Hook to the head there by Thompson.
Misses a huge hook to the head.
Oh, that's a big block, Joe.
He got tagged there.
Well, it's one thing to have length, it's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Tom. Worked hard for that single leg takedown. No good. Under 2 minutes to go.
Calf guard. Good shot to the head. Excellent posture.
Bro, how you not gonna let me out?
Now it lands a devastating strike to the head.
He's in full guard. And he's back up again. Nice. Really missed it.
And he's out, baby.
Big ground and pound KO.
Yeah, Joe, that was some outstanding ground and pound to get the opponent out of there. He was throwing big shots there on the ground, man. Not just looking to score, but actually looking to end the fight and to make sure the judges stay firmly out of this equation. Elbows, punches, hammer fists, everything seemed to be working for him here tonight.
Here we see it from a different angle. Check it out again. Boom! Right on the money.
So there he is after a monumental knockout turned in here tonight. That is one they will be talking about for quite some time. Bruce Buffer now with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mariano's going to stop for this contest at 4 minutes, 20 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by...
Yeah, raise up my hand.
So there he is, the man of the moment. Certainly maximized the showcase here tonight, Joey. Gets a big win by way of the knockout. Certainly kept the judges out of it here tonight. Perhaps some bonus money is coming his way, but there will be no wiping the smile off of his face tonight. He will...
I'm still here. Davies, talk that talk. Streets need that. NYC, LA, Chicago, Detroit, the whole world. Let's get it.
Diana beat the queen, get out the projects and never look back. Could still smell love wrong from when my uncle was. Between homies, better yet brothers, they used to spend the night with each other. They moms was best friends. One name was Anthony, the other called him.
He was KO'd. I hit him with that.
He got a little colder the moment he watched me and die. That was 10 years ago. Mm-hmm. Baby, he's wishing that his beard would grow. Now he's throwing set up anyway. Go. He's just a product of his environment. Told me he'd rather die than never go to righteous again. Did his beard, his belly was blood. He studied 5%. Came home, I let you see me. I'll never ride with that. Corey was his right hand, me and his mother up north. She was busting checks with the wrong. Pop seniors and he just want him some strong liquor. Lose the attitude, he miserable. For years he tried to get a liquor. So mom's begging he finished school, but nonsense he getting soup. Aunt met Corey when they was kids with innocence. Aunt needed his dad around because that was militant. Corey found a older pass, so cash they could triple it. Double it, stack it all, Corey ain't never wanna spend. Ain't was throwing money fast, big reaching when he shot, flash shot, body wrapped in diamonds, nothing in the watch.
Oh yeah, I'm making for the mention. We got a new gym. You know, I'm bougie like that. You know, I like to be some of that fight.
They robbed him, but he got it back. 6 in the morning with baggies on him. What's the way of life? Treat the piece too quick. Ain't nothing free. Pay the price. Eviction notice in the kitchen. Your bitches stay the night. Corey had the sideware. Ain't with Yola. Got kicked out his mom. He a couple boulders. I locked up with killers up north. He rubbed a couple shoulders. Corey told in on the Vienna block was changing.
Right. But get this fight on and take another dub. Hopefully, don't lose this one.
All right, coming up next into UFC flyweight division matchup. Well, this is an outstanding kickboxer making his way to the UFC Octagon right now. Very interesting stylistic matchup here tonight. Just an outstanding arsenal of kicks. Great punching technique. Power in both hands. Works the lead leg. Not afraid to work the body. Just a complete kickboxer here. Now plying his trade in mixed martial arts. A dangerous proposition for anyone caught in his striking range.
This guy is an outstanding striker. What he wants to do is use his defense to keep the fight standing, use the takedown defense and a good solid sprawl, and if he does go to the ground, make sure he gets back up and punishes his opponent.
Well, the crowd pops as this guy makes the walk to the Octagon, and you can see why if you've watched film on him. This is a true mixed martial artist, plus skills in all areas, and figures to be a handful, really, for anybody in this division. Probably comfortable tonight anywhere the fight goes. Truly a well-rounded MMA fighter. You know, we trot that term out there a lot. This guy fits the bill.
This guy is a very well-rounded fighter. He can do it all. If the fight takes place standing or on the ground, he's going to be comfortable in all areas of the game.
And now our tail to take for this flyweight tilt. More than 5 years apart. Some differences in height and reach as well. All right, now to get us started, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC flyweight division. Introducing us.
Fighting out of the corner. Yeah, call my name.
Only professional record of five wins, one loss. He's had 5 inches tall, weighing in at 120 pounds. Fighting from the Washington, USA.
Oh,
and now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the right corner, a Muay Thai kickboxer and jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 6 wins, 5 losses. He can't find the 40 tall, weighing in at 124 pounds. Wrestling.
Yo, why his chin look like that? That is kind of weird.
Dan Murphy out of here, referee.
You ready?
First round underway. All right, so here we go with round one. This young contender has won his last 3 fights, and as many of you know, each knockout more impressive than the last. He'll try to extend the knockout streak here tonight to continue his path toward title contention. We'll see if he can keep it going here tonight.
He's mixing things up really well, too, from the hands to the
chest. Like it! Yeah! Oh!
Big shot.
All right, so he just decides to get up here, Joe. Oh, man, defensively leaving a lot to be desired there. He moved right into that hook. His head was wide open.
Oh, that was a good dive, so I'm not going to give him a shot. I won't lie about it.
That one hurt.
Oh, shoot. Oh, no.
How about that shin?
Doing a great job of timing these shots. Caught that one on the forearm.
Oh, nice sequence of jabs there, turned in by Thompson. Now closes the distance.
Oh, nice body shot.
Using his jab effectively here, it's an underutilized weapon by a lot of fighters, not this guy.
Oh, tagged him. Another one.
Oh, his face is painted with blood, Joe. The cut on that cheek not getting any better.
Inside leg kick.
In on a single here.
Yep. You ain't getting me, son.
In half guard.
We'll see what he does here. He postures up and lands to the head. Well, he postures up again and delivers another big ground and pound strike. Beautiful sequence there by Thompson.
Clean punch. That's a good shot from the bottom.
Oh, worked hard to get up again, but he looks like he's compromised. Wow!
He's in big trouble.
Oh, he might be out. Oh!
What a leg kick!
Oh! The jab followed by the right hand. Oh!
Big punches here. Back to his feet again. Amazing.
Big body shot.
Shot there too.
Oh! The owl boy. With 10 seconds left to spare.
Beautiful KO just as the round was ending.
Wow, Joe, just incredible. Just when I thought I was going to start asking you about what adjustments they could make for the next round, we get the end of the fight. A huge shot to drop his opponent. The referee wisely jumps in to stop the action there. Near perfect execution on that fight ending sequence.
Let's look at that again. Let's see that again. Boom! And then he's out.
And there he is after the huge knockout turned in tonight. Near perfect execution and one of the bigger highlights of his UFC career. All right, now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Margliotta has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 50 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout.
So there's the man of the moment, just the way he drew it up here tonight as he gets his hand raised and does so emphatically by way of the KO. Perhaps some bonus money is coming his way at the end of the night. I'm not sure. Still a few fights to go. But at the very least, you can be sure his next fight will be a big one, and he will celebrate deep into the night with his teammates, his coaches, and his friends after this monumental victory here under the bright
lights. Well, guys, I'll see you next time. Malik on Fleek 3.0 out.